Hi guys, welcome to the video. Well, after nearly 3 years, I've finally got my Hawker Hurricane finished. So in this video, I'm going to show you the Maiden Flight. But before we go on to the Maiden Flight, we'll just go through some of the build stages so you can just get a little overview of it. If you're not bothered about that, I'll put a time link on the top where you can jump straight to the Maiden Flight. So as you can see, guys, I use my hot wire CNC to make the wings and fuselage for the Hurricane. The tail and the rudder were just cut out from the plan. And here's the formers being cut out on the machine. This video is quite old, and it's running a lot faster, around about 20 times, I think. It'd be nice if it did run this quick. I think in total there was 15 formers here, as you can see here. And then we've got the wing sections as well. So all this was done on a hot wire CNC machine. And I just stuck them together with some masking tape down the side to hold it together. Here she is with all the formers glued together and the wings made. And the wings were made in the same way, using the hot wire CNC machine. This isn't actually the Hurricane, this was in one of my flying wings, but the process is exactly the same. To generate the G-code for the wings, I use Profili 2 Pro, but there are some free options available, and I'll put some links in the description. And for the fuselage, I used DevFus foam, and that's been upgraded to DevFus foam 2. And here I am checking the incidence on the tail to the wing, making sure I've got zero between the two. This works really well, this, because it's a digital gauge, so I'll link to a video with some more details on that. And I've covered it in foil glass and poly-C. And as you can see here, I'm making some exhaust stacks. These were designed in Fusion 360, which was a bit of a challenge, but they didn't turn out too bad. So I've just got them mocked up here. And in the end, I've painted them sort of a darker brown than the rest of it. I didn't want it black because I think they'd just stand out too much. And here she is, finally finished. So I'll just do a little bit of a walk around here. All the decals were cut out by hand, and everything on here you can see has been made by hand, apart from motors and propellers, obviously. And now we're ready for the Maiden Flight. So Pete's doing the honours with the hand launch, and Martin's doing a bit of extra film work. The undercarriage you just saw in the previous picture was just for display purposes, so I thought it looked better than just laid on the ground. So here we go. Phew, that was a relief.
She flies. A bit lively. Yeah, she could do with a bit of upping, I think.
Oh, you're mod one, aren't you?
Yeah.
Decreasing your throttle, what about that?
As I said previously, it was quite a windy day when I filmed this video. When I got back and listen to the video, the wind noise was terrible on it. So I've managed to get rid of quite a lot of it, but there's still some there. So I was using a GoPro session. So what I need to do is put in a few fixes and try and get rid of that wind noise for future videos. She flew really well, and I was quite pleased, really, and I was quite nervous on the Maiden Flight, because when you've done everything from scratch, you never know whether you've got the CG in the right place. And but I think I've built a few now, and I was reasonably confident she would fly okay, but there's nothing like the actual proof of the pudding. I hadn't actually spent 3 years in total building the Hurricane. I'd got the fuselage and wings done quite quickly, but then one thing and another, and I sort of lost a little bit of motivation for it part way through the build. But then I got my mojo back for it, and decided this year I had to get it finished, and she's actually turned out a lot better than I thought. And as you can see from the picture, she's done in the desert camouflage colours, known as the Tank Buster, or another name for them was the Desert Tin Opener. I mean, a lot of people say that a Hurricane with its 40mm cannons could never knock a Tiger tank out, but in a lot of cases you didn't have to knock the tank out, all you had to knock out was the supply trucks. So if there's no fuel, then the tanks can't run, and that's what they were really good at. So we're lining up for landing now, and I was a little bit nervous about this because of the, it was quite windy that day, but luckily I nailed it on the first landing. I had a second flight which I didn't make as nice a landing, but it was okay. So many thanks to Pete for doing the launch and the helpful advice during the maiden flight. Martin for taking some great video, and Nathan for taking some great still shots of the Hurricane in flight while it was flying. So guys, this is the fourth video in the Hurricane series. The first video shows the wings being made. The second one shows using DevFus foam to create the fuselage. And then the third video is an update showing various little issues and how I've got over them. I've also started a series on using DevFus foam too to build a BAE Hawk, or the T-45 Goshawk as used by the US Navy. So I'll put links into them as well. Thanks for watching guys, and catch you later.